Oh my goodness! Hey, what's up guys? Welcome back to the lab. Today we're filming this video in the dark because we're doing something a little bit different. I had a comment pop up from Jacob Militello who said, try to get a plasma globe and break the glass and turn it on and see what happens. So Jacob, I went on Amazon and I picked this thing up. This was a $500 plasma globe. It's about the biggest one I could find and it just arrived the other day. So I got my trusty sledgehammer. We got this globe powered up. So let's go ahead and smash the glass and see if we can answer your question. Now before we actually smash this thing open, I thought it would be fun to play with it and kind of explore the properties of a plasma globe. What is it? How does it work? What's it made of? Now I have to admit when this thing first arrived, I picked it up and kind of thought it was fake because it's extremely, extremely light. And I would have thought that this dome was made of glass. On feeling it, it almost feels like it's made of plastic, although when I look at it, I can actually see ridge lines in there. So the question I want to answer first is this actually glass or is it plastic? Because if we try smashing it with our hammer, I actually want it to crack. I don't want it to just, you know, do a little seam line and destroy the whole thing. So I'm guessing this is glass, but I'm not 100% sure. Now, if we take a look at the back of the power adapter here, you can see how much power is going in and how much is being converted. It's pulling house power and converting it to 12 volts at about 3 amps. If you look inside the globe, you'll see this little center tower, and that's essentially a Tesla coil, and it steps that 12 volts up to somewhere in the thousands of volts. Now, it could be 2,000 volts or it could be 20,000 volts. At this point, I don't really have any way of knowing because there's no markings anywhere on the unit itself. Now, if you remember my thank you video where we passed 7 million subscribers, I went to a science center and found a giant plasma globe like this and used a piece of aluminum foil to actually draw the arc outside of the globe. And we're gonna see if we can do that with this one as well. All we have to do is take a piece of aluminum foil and put it down on top of the glass, and this builds up a capacitive charge. And if we take something like a piece of metal and touch it with our fingers, we can actually get close to the metal and get those sparks to jump out. You can see the spark is quite a bit smaller than the one that we had at the science center, and that's because the power pumping through this thing is substantially less. And even though we can use it to burn holes in a piece of paper, it's not quite enough to actually light the paper off. Now the next question I have in my mind is this dome made of plastic or is it actually glass? My question comes because it's extremely lightweight, which makes it hard to believe this is glass, but we should be able to tell pretty easily by taking the tip of a screwdriver and giving it a gentle tap. Okay, so it's got a very sharp ting and you can actually hear it resonating on the inside. If you look really closely, you can see the ridges and the swirls where it looks like the glass was blown and expanded. So I am confident this is glass, which means it should shatter under the weight of our hammer.
Yeah.
All right, so good news guys, it looks like our globe is glass. We've got thousands of volts of electricity pumping in here. The question is, what happens now if we take our hammer and we smash the glass while this thing is running? Is the electricity gonna jump out? Is it gonna kill me? Is there gonna be any safety concern at all? We don't know. That's what we're here to find out. Let's get to it. Now, I'm putting my glasses on for safety, but it really would be better to have some kind of a full face shield because we don't exactly know what's inside of this globe. Is it under vacuum pressure or is it filled with some kind of inert gas like argon or nitrogen? We're not exactly sure, but we have seen from previous experiments with vacuum chambers that when it smashes, it implodes and basically falls straight down. So that is a risk I'm willing to take for you. However, I'm gonna put on some heavier duty gloves first. The other thing that I noticed is if I pulled my hand on the globe here and I accidentally touch any exposed skin to the aluminum trim around my workbench, it gives me a little bite. I can actually feel the electricity jumping through my body. Cool. I can actually smell like burning hair or burning flesh. I wonder if I should like tilt this and actually like hold it in my hand as I smash it. It's super cool. You can see, look at the way my fingers glow in the back of the globe. See, I think I'm gonna do it. I'm actually just gonna hold this while I smash it because that seems like the unsafe thing to do, doesn't it? Whew. Okay, this is where I start getting a little bit nervous, guys. But we're gonna do it. Here we go in 3, 2, 1. Oh my goodness! Holy heck, I could not have predicted that. That did not implode, that exploded. That like shot glass out everywhere, all over my workbench. It didn't cut me though. And look here, the electricity doesn't appear to actually be shooting anymore. I'm not sure if it turned off. That was amazing. We gotta look at the replay on that. Look at all this glass, look at all the shards. Oh my goodness, that was incredible. Okay, so watching this on the slow-mo replay, here's the windup. Hammer's coming down, makes contact, and interesting, like the top of the dome kind of flew upwards and then everything underneath just kind of like imploded and fell down. So that was really interesting, guys. So I can't tell if it exploded or imploded. It would kind of like sheared in half, the top popped off, and everything else just fell down. All I can say is there was a tremendous amount of force and that was a lot louder than I was expecting. All I can say is I feel really lucky. I have no cuts, no damage. I'm no worse for wear. Look at this. This is the glass. And what's really interesting about this is if you look at this side of the glass, it's extremely thin. But then you look at this side and it's substantially thicker. So like, obviously, the glass changes thicknesses as well. That's pretty bizarre. I wouldn't have expected that. And because that popped off so dramatically, I'm wondering if whatever gas was inside there was actually pressurized. Like, this might have actually been under pressure. If it were a vacuum, it would have sucked in, but I'm pretty sure that was a pop. That was like an explosion outward. So maybe pressurized argon or pressurized nitrogen is in there. Now this is crazy, guys. The dome is gone. You don't see any more arcs flailing around. I don't feel any charge in the atmosphere. I don't see any electricity, but if I touch it, you can actually hear it buzzing, you can hear it hissing. And if I take the tip of a screwdriver and touch it, you can see little arcs start flying. They're not nearly as dramatic as the long octopus arms that were inside the dome, because I think there's only a couple thousand volts of electricity there. Because we're in the standard atmosphere now with nitrogen and oxygen, it just doesn't have the same effect. So yeah, basically if you pay $500 for a plasma globe of your own, don't smash it open. It looks a lot cooler if you just leave it on your table and let it roll. Oh, and if you look really closely, you can actually see a purple glow around my fingers. Can you see that? It gets really hot though. Like, that heats up really fast. You know, the crazy thing about this is you can see the arcs flying into the tip of the screwdriver and my finger's right beside it making contact, but I feel absolutely nothing. Oh, what? What the heck just happened there? Oh, are we melting the glass? Something weird is happening. I can actually draw this arc out substantially now. I wonder what changed to make that happen. Like, did we actually crack the glass? Did we burn a hole through it, maybe? Interesting that it's traveling upward, probably because the heat of the flame is rising. Well, there you have it, guys. We made an epic mess. Glass everywhere. I'm gonna have to get busy cleaning this up. But we did this for you, Jacob, to help answer that burning question you had as to what happens if you smash the glass on a plasma globe and turn it on. You can go check your YouTube inbox, Jacob. I'm sending you $25. Hey, thanks for joining us for this experiment. We'll be looking for you in the next one. Talk to you then. Clean up on aisle 3. I'm saying that a lot these days. Whoa. Dang it. Hey guys, I wanted to jump back in for just a second to invite you to come follow me on Instagram. I've got a very active page where I post daily pictures and stories of behind the scenes and every day is an adventure. Just take 5 seconds right now to click the link in the description to come follow me on Instagram at The King of Random, and I'll see you there.